Hello and welcome. In this video, we are going to prove this theorem here on the screen, which states that if a function f, which is equal to the function u plus I times the function v, is analytic, then we know that the function u and the function v are harmonic functions. And we are going to prove this theorem by using the Cauchy-Riemann equations and the fact that an analytic function must fulfill these equations. And hopefully in the end, we will be able to show that the function u and the function v satisfy the definition for them to be harmonic functions. So let's get going. So since we know from the theorem that the function f must be an analytic function, we get that the Laplace equation here for the function u, which also can be written as the following expression. And I'm only doing this because this will hopefully make the next step a little bit more clear. Because the next step is to use the Cauchy-Riemann equations to rewrite this expression as the following. And now we just have to prove that these two terms are the same, just with opposite signs. And we can do that once again by using the fact that the function f is analytic. Because if a function f is analytic, then it should be infinite differentiable. And that means that the function v and the function u should be infinite differentiable as well. And therefore, we can draw the conclusion that the function v has continuous second-order partial derivatives, which makes these two terms here the same, since the order of mixed derivatives doesn't matter for this function. And that is great, because now we have that the Laplace equation for function u is indeed equal to zero. And since we know that the function u is infinite differentiable, we also know that it must have continuous second-order partial derivatives. And therefore, the function u satisfy all the requirements for it to be a harmonic function. And now we can do the exact same thing for a function v instead. We start by rewriting the Laplace equation for a function v with the help of the Cauchy-Riemann equations. And then we use the fact that the function u have continuous second-order partial derivatives. So these two terms here are the same, but with opposite signs. So the whole thing is equal to zero. And therefore, the function v fulfills the Laplace equation and have continuous second-order partial derivatives, since the function itself is infinite differentiable. And therefore, the function is a harmonic function. Thanks for watching.